Let's go party.
Hey everyone, it's Take 10 with Shane and Michelle, and guess where we are today?
Ooh, I don't know.
I think we might be last to the $1 billion Barbie party, but we
made it. Okay, we gave in.
We really gave in.
Because I never had Barbies. Did you have Barbies?
You know, I did.
You did?
But my sister actually was a Barbie fanatic, and
okay.
Our daughter
yeah.
was big into Barbies. I dabbled.
So I pushed Michaela away from Barbies because I didn't want to deal with all those little pieces, you know, around the house.
Yeah, we had a lot of pieces, a lot of legs and arms and body parts all over the house.
All over. So,
but yeah, it was fun. It was something fun and girly.
Yeah. So I gave in. I did ask what color I should wear. I gave in to pink. Thank you guys. You voted. I wore pink. So I will say neither one of us has watched any reviews. I personally, like in my circle, don't know anybody who's seen it. Mm. I did a poll. So you guys, thank you for taking my poll. It was really split. It was like 57-43 of people who had seen it and who didn't see it.
Oh, okay. Well, I do know people that have seen
it.
Okay. Sporting my pink Barbie nails, when I was up in Ohio, I went to my favorite nail technician, shout out to Mary, over to Lure Nail Studio in Lewis Center. Anyway, one of the women in my demographic, we were just sitting chatting, and she goes, oh, those look like Barbie pink nails. I saw the movie, not once, but twice.
Oh,
and
boy.
I said, well, I don't have to ask you. If you saw it twice, you probably loved it. And she said, yes. She told me nothing.
I did listen to the music on the way here.
Oh, what'd you think?
Ryan Gosling, he did a really good job on his, and they've done a really good job of like putting the hip hop, like some updated music in it
too. I did hear it has a nice soundtrack.
Margot Robbie,
I don't know how you pronounce her last name, Ryan Gosling. I mean, I'm looking forward to two of them together anyway. That'll be good. But I mean,
all right.
Let's go.
Let's go get some popcorn and check it out.
Sounds great.
All right. Well, that was it. I will have to say, it was emotional at the end.
It really was. Very emotional at the end.
It was very good.
Excellent. Excellent story. I was trying to put my finger on. It was more than a female empowerment story. Of course, that was running through it. It was all about being you.
Yeah. Yeah.
And it didn't matter male or female in the end.
Yeah, and I learned a lot. I learned about the different Barbies that I had no idea, like, they rid of or retired
or
whatever.
So that part, the nostalgic part, I thought was really, really cool. They wove in a lot of the historical Barbies, which was really neat.
Yeah, the different names, too, was very interesting. But it got emotional when they talked about the lady who started Mattel did it for her daughter.
Yes, her daughter was named Barbara. Her name was Ruth. And
that was emotional.
That was really, really
very
neat.
Very sweet.
Yes. And
they're like, I want Michaela to watch it.
Yeah, it's a great, I think that's, we won't do any spoilers.
No spoilers.
It is a great mother-daughter movie for sure.
It is.
And you'll see why if you come watch it.
Yeah.
It was, that part was really good. It was funny. It was really funny, too.
It was good. Ken is hysterical.
Oh.
And I guess I didn't realize there was an Alan.
I don't think I knew there was an Alan. I think the true Mattel or Barbie and Ken aficionados out there, you knew about Alan? Comment below because we didn't know. We didn't know about Alan.
Well, there will be more review later.
Yeah, we'll definitely. We'll add some thoughts once we regroup. We're in the theater here, and I think they're getting ready to kick us out.
Yeah, I think they're kicking us out.
So more to come. Hey, everyone. It's Take 10 with Shane and Michelle, and we promised you a deeper dive review of the Barbie movie, and here we are 4 days later. But Shane, it's not just you and I.
No, and you know what? Barbie is now the $1 billion Barbie movie.
It
who would have thunk?
Uh, I never, ever would have thought it would hit $1 billion. Actually, Shane, we can probably share the secret that you and I weren't even planning to go see this movie.
We were not.
I had Barbies. Would I classify myself as a Barbie girl growing up? No. My sister was a Barbie girl, and our daughter Katie would have been a Barbie girl. So very familiar with Barbies. And I think we just wanted to see what all the fuss was about.
We did. Lori, I heard you saw it twice. Seriously?
I did. So I saw it the first time with my husband. And I bawled
my eyes. You got a husband to go to the Barbie movie?
Oh, yeah.
You tell.
He loved it. He was into it.
Good.
So, yeah. And I bawled my eyes out the first time. And so I told all my girlfriends here that it was a great movie. And it had a great message and great things. And I said, we should all do a girls' dive. So we all dressed up in pink and we went. There was four of us that won. So we saw it a second time.
Fun. Yep. Well, so your husband, so the, no hesitation.
Nope.
And he liked it.
He did. He really did.
Okay, so, I have to ask. I'm so sorry. How old is the husband?
He's in his 50s.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm surprised y'all didn't bring your husbands.
We know.
You met my husband.
Did you ask? Did you offer?
What'd you talk about? So, number one, didn't offer. but there wasn't even a question for me.
Yeah.
But
I think every man should be dragged to that movie.
So Emma, so who did you see it with?
Okay, well, as she was talking about her seeing it the second time, I forgot that I did see it twice. I did. The second time was a date, and I forgot about it. Maybe I was nervous, and I blocked it out of my memory, but I forgot I saw it twice.
Wait, the whoa. Emma, you took a date to the Barbie movie?
He wanted to go see it. We were texting, and he was like, I want to take you on a date. And at first, I was like, oh, I don't want to, like, get ready, because I was at the pool all day. He was like, let's go see Barbie. I said, yes, please, let's go see Barbie. So we went. He liked it. Yeah.
Anyway. Okay, our guys were missing out, I guess.
He liked it.
Maybe we should do a second review with me and you and the two guys.
Just the cameras on them during the movie.
Yeah. Well,
what did you guys expect the movie was about, and did it meet or exceed your expectations? Let's talk about that a little bit.
I didn't have any expectations. I didn't read anything. I just had heard. So part of the reason I wanted to go is because I heard so many men in the States saying it was a stupid movie. They'd never go, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, all right, now I just have to see it just because I want to know what this movie is. Because the first thing in my mind was that old song, I'm a Barbie girl in a Barbie world. I'm like, is it going to be that dumb? Just Margot Robbie is amazing. Like, absolutely. They couldn't have picked a better Barbie, if you ask me.
Right.
And when I saw that Barbie dream house, I was like, I've wanted to go down that slide my entire life. And that car. So, and then it was just like, I had that Barbie and yes. I did that. And oh, I never got that. And it just, so those were the heartstrings of that. So going through that was really, like, really empowering. And then the one scene with America Ferrara, I bawled my eyes out. So I don't think I recovered after that. So
yes.
When we were done, I looked at my husband and I said, I have to come back and see this again because I think I missed a lot because I was bawling.
It's hard to get it all in through the tears on a movie, isn't it?
So the second time I went through, I really paid attention to Ryan Gosling's side.
Oh, that's an interesting way to do it.
And yeah. It was like, I was like, oh my God, now I don't know which person I like the best. Like now I want to go see it a third time to put it together because I'm like,
no, this is the no judgment zone, Lori. We won't judge you for that.
But it was just so like you see the whole, you know, Barbie side and then you see the whole Ken side. And it's just completely different, right? But you never think of that. And I'm like, oh, yeah, you know, my Ken doll as a kid, because I was a Barbie girl. My Ken doll, I broke his neck. when he was little, you know, when I was little, and he always had tape around his neck. So I'm like, yeah, so he always was like a secondhand citizen. So
wow, that is that's
did you have Alan?
Yeah, did you know about Alan?
No, I didn't know. I wish had no I knew idea about Alan.
But Alan is my new favorite. Yes. I love Alan.
No. I want an Alan doll now.
I love Alan.
So Emma, did you have Barbies?
I had a few. Me and my sisters were mainly like Polly Pocket and American Girl doll girls, but I had a few. And I think they were just blonde, you know, I don't remember much about them. But we watched a lot of the Barbie movies when we were younger. So it was kind of cool to see like how they brought that to life a little bit too. But following Lori, I didn't have any expectations either. I had no idea what it would be about. But it really surprised me. Like, I was shocked when I left. Like, I got emotional. I didn't cry or anything. But, like, I didn't know how to feel because I wasn't expecting any of it. And I feel like throughout the whole movie, there are so many different things you can pick apart. It, like, all came at me. And I was like, this is, like, it was, like, a mind-blown experience. It was a really great movie. I loved everything about it.
All right. So, how was it seeing it with a date? Now, that's a curveball.
I know. No, it was. I mean, since I had already seen it, like I was almost like waiting for his reaction when everything was happening. But I mean, it wasn't anything weird. Or
was it a first date? Or
no, we had hung out before.
Okay. Who do you think the movie's for? I mean, obviously we all saw it. Who do you think it's for?
I think it's for the young girls. Like I will have to say the one thing we mothers stand still so our daughters can look back to see how far they've come. I think we all do that. I didn't realize, you know, that kind of thing, but I think we all do that as mothers. We want our girls to be able to go as far or farther than what we have, to be better than whatever. So I think it is an empowerment for girls. And to be honest with you, I didn't know that there was all those different types of Barbies. I only thought it was the blonde Barbie and the Barbie. And I will have to say, I was like, you know, they're always a Barbie girl like that. You know what I mean? I didn't know that the Dr. Barbie, Lawyer Barbie, I didn't know all those even really existed because I didn't play with Barbie. So I learned a lot. Midge, Alan, like all of those.
Was Midge the pregnant one that Mattel said?
Yes. The weird one. Yeah. Real. She was real.
She was real, Lori?
Yes. You all of those were that? Real dolls. Yep.
Yes. Okay. Now, my sister growing up, she would mutilate the Barbies. So she would be the weird Barbie. Yes. The poor weird Barbie probably was having nightmares about my sister. and she would color them, but to put makeup on, she would cut their hair in order to, because she also had do you guys remember the big Barbie head?
Did you put makeup on?
You can cut their hair. And my sister is a hairdresser. She became a hairdresser. That is her profession. Very favorite scene in the movie.
Lori?
America Ferrara. Her speech was by far something like, I found it on the internet and I think I sent it to like 10 female friends and said, if you never see the movie, you have to watch this.
You know, I could barely breathe during it because as she was saying it, I was just like, oh my gosh. Shane and I did not chat during the movie much. We didn't really make eye contact during the movie. We met a few other women who brought their 80 to 90 year old mother. We're like, why is she there? She was there for Ryan Gosling. The 85-year-old woman. But that was an excellent, excellent scene.
My husband kept holding my hand during that time and going, are you okay? Because I was just like, oh my gosh, this is so empowering. And she spoke the truth. And I think if something in, because it was a pretty long monologue, but it, something in there had to resonate with every woman that was in the theater, something. Yeah. And it was just outstanding, especially for women in business too, right? I mean, Michelle, you've gone through, it's probably like I have, it's, you're not always looked at, you know, it's just so much like, wow. Just, wow.
Oh yeah. Yeah, yeah, in our field for sure at the top. I feel it. I felt it for decades.
My favorite scene was probably the end where like all the flashbacks or the memories are like coming to life and she's kind of just tearing up, and that was the most emotional part for me, and it just put like life into perspective. Like no matter what age you are. I kind of wanted to piggyback on the question that Shane or that you asked us earlier about who the movie's for.
Yeah.
And I definitely want to say it's for everybody. I know that's a cliche answer, but like Shane said, it's for young women. The women empowerment within the film is amazing and outstanding. I think it's for men. Like, I think every man should go see that movie.
I agree with you on that. Yeah. I think it's ageless. I would not have said that pre just looking at the trailers or the really great. I mean, talk about a marketing machine genius that they did for this movie.
And they chose the right actors.
Oh, like, for sure.
They did a great job.
Oh, they did a great job.
I wouldn't change a thing.
Yeah.
The other thing that I thought was interesting is like when my girlfriends and I saw it together, we all had pink on and we came outside and we're standing around and we have the littlest girls in pink and women that are in their 80s and 90s in pink. Yes. So right there, and men in pink. So yes. It was like, this is for everyone. This yes. isn't, and there was not a sad look on, I mean, everybody was smiling, like everybody.
Yes. And I feel like the film was like such a good way to bring women especially together. Like she said, everybody was wearing pink. Everybody was excited. Like, and everybody, one time I tried to go the first time, it was on a Sunday. And there were times from like 11 a.m. all the way until 9 p.m. And there, every single seat was pretty much full. Like I was sitting, I had a bad seat. Like I was kind of close up to the front, but every single seat was full. And there were so many times, like I've never seen that in my life for a movie before. So it just goes to show how big it is and everybody wanting to see it and everything like that.
There's been a lot of good movies through the decades, right? That we would say are, you know, great reviews, you tell everybody about it and you're excited, the word of mouth is really powerful, but very few reach $1 billion.
Yeah,
that is an elite
crazy
group. And so why did this reach $1 billion?
Well, I'm gonna answer my question on that is because, and I, you know, maybe I didn't get into the Barbie thing, but the one that hit me the most was, what was I made for? Everybody has that answer or that question in their life, no matter if you're a Barbie, you're a human, you're a person, you're a mom. What was I made for?
Just going to say, and speaking of about women, when you said, why is it $1 billion?
Yeah,
it started with a woman. It was the woman director and writer.
Mm.
So it was all women based. It was, you know, Margot Robbie was a producer. I mean,
yeah.
Ryan Gosling was part of that. I mean, it was starting with people that were super smart, and it was women.
Absolutely.
So, and it's the most highest grossing female director in all time.
What about Ray Perlman?
She was just adorable in this.
She's just, and it's interesting because Shane and I just went, and we'll plug for anyone watching who has not seen our review of Disney's Haunted Mansion movie. Please click the link on that because we reviewed that, and her husband, Danny DeVito, was in Haunted Mansion. and I'm, you know what? They are still married, right? I mean, I'm pretty sure they've been together for decades.
I think so. I don't think
they're married. I'm pretty sure they're still married. But anyway, just her playing that role, you know, as the founder and creator, I should say. She was just great. She didn't have a huge role, but she had a very powerful, important role.
And it was authentic, right? Because she said about her issues, right? Her challenge with the IRS and everything else that we all know about. And being able to bring in Mattel, like I'm thinking, Michelle, even in your business, I mean, that is like the cash cow, right? To be able to take a company and link it in there, even to the point of when the female president started swearing and the Mattel sign comes up.
I love that when they bleeped her out. Yes.
Genius.
Yeah.
Let's have one final thought from each of us that, like, when you left that theater and it was like, I'm going a third time. Like, what was that? What was your final thought, Lori?
And why other people should go see it?
Yeah. Because it takes the matriarch and the patriarch, and it shows why they're important to work together.
Love that. Love that.
Emma?
I feel like it was definitely the girl power, you know, movement and the emotional power of women in it as well. And I feel like everybody should go see it because it talks about a lot of topics that women go through and what we have to do on a daily basis that men don't quite understand. And I feel like that was why this movie had a lot of pushback. It was a anti-men film, which is definitely not true. It was just a pro-woman film. So I feel like a lot of men kind of misinterpreted it. But it also is kind of ironic because when they, like, when other people are saying, oh, it's just, you know, talking bad about men, talking bad about Black, but like, how do you think we feel all this time being objectified and everything like that from men? So that's why I feel like men should definitely go see it.
I agree with you. I love how you said that. And I would add on to that, pro-human at the end. It really was. Absolutely. And I just think being your authentic self was super important. And that was the message that was loud and clear to me. And at the end of the day, regardless of the deeper message, everybody, it was just fun and entertaining. And we talked about crying, but we laughed just as much.
Yes.
And so, Shane,
I agree. I was going to say, you know, Michelle, I think we have to go again.
We may have to go again with another eye. It would love to go with you ladies as well if we all lived in the same place. But I think that's a wrap. Thank you, everyone, for tuning in to find out all the hype about the, we're calling it the $1 billion Barbie party. And we'll see how much it is not been pulled from the theater yet. We will see how far above the billion. And I want to see stats on how many people see it once, twice, three times or more. So that's definitely the sign of a successful film. So until then, everybody, make all your moments magical.
In Florida and beyond.
Thank you, Lori. Take care, everybody.